Hey, what's going on guys, Sandeep here, and if your Windows 11 is running slow, then in this video you will see some tips and workaround to make your Windows 11 run much faster. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So the first thing is Storage Sense. Go to Menu and then Settings, or you can search for Settings app if you are not getting in pinned options. Then go to System option and then Storage. Now you have to enable Storage Sense. If you enable Storage Sense, Windows will automatically delete junk file from your computer. So you need to enable Storage Sense option on your Windows 11. And then click on Cleanup Recommendations. And then select See Advanced Options. And here you have to check all these options except Downloads. If you check Downloads, it will delete your downloaded files as well. So make sure you uncheck Downloads, and then rest you can check. And then click on Remove Files. It will clear clutter from your Windows 11, I mean C drive, and that will make your Windows 11 run smoother. Now second thing is about adjusting privacy settings. Click on Privacy and Security option, then go to General option, and here you can disable all these options. So you have to turn off these options in the General option. So disable all these options and then go back to Privacy and Security option again, and then Speech option, turn off online speech recognition. If you are not using any kind of online speech services, then you can disable it. Then go to Inking and Typing Personalization and turn it off if you don't want any typing suggestion from Microsoft. And then go to Diagnostic and Feedback, and then you can disable Send Optional Diagnostic Data. But if you have joined Windows Insider program, you have to keep this option enabled. In my case, I have joined Windows Insider program, so I have to enable this option, but you can disable it so that it won't send data from your computer to Microsoft. Now go back to Privacy and Security option and then App Permissions. Under App Permissions, click on Location option, and then you can disable the Location option if you are not using any location services like Maps or any kind of services that require location. Go back to App Permission again and then click on Camera option. If you are not using webcam, Zoom call or doing any video call on your computer, then you can disable the camera access. But if you are using, then you can keep it enabled. And now click on Notifications option, and then you can turn off notification access for the apps. Go back to App Permissions and then go to Messaging options. If you are not using this People app or any other messaging related services on Windows 11, then you can disable it. Radios, you should enable this option. You should not disable this, because some people say you should disable radios. But if you disable it, your Bluetooth might not work. And you can disable the permission for the apps which you are not using, like contacts, phone calls, call history, emails. If you are not using email client, default email client, you can disable it. Or any apps which you are not using, you can disable the permissions. Now let's go back to System option and then Notifications. Now scroll down to bottom, Advanced Settings. Now you can uncheck this option, Get Tips and Suggestions when using Windows. This way you won't get any promoted apps or suggestions while using Windows. So you can turn off this feature. Now the next thing is about deleting unwanted apps. Go to Apps option and then Installed App. Here you have to find which apps you are not using and uninstall them. There are tons of default app, pre-installed apps which you can uninstall. So if you are not using those apps, you can uninstall them. It will free up some memory on your computer and it will disable their related services. That will free up system resources for other apps and programs. So you can uninstall the apps which you are not using. Now go back to Apps option again, and then click on Startup option. Now sort by status and disable all the startup items you are not using. I mean, you can disable all these startup items except antivirus. So disable them all except antivirus. Now the next thing is about adjusting visual effects on your Windows 11. Press Windows plus R key together on your keyboard and type there sysdm.cpl and then click on OK. Go to Advanced tab and then click on Settings under Performance. Now click on Adjust for Best Performance. But you have to enable some visual effects after that, so that your Windows 11 won't look ugly. So you can enable these options. And I will mention all these options which you need to enable in the video description as well. So you can keep these options enabled, hit Apply, then OK. Then OK. And the next thing is about disabling Xbox Game Bar. Go to Menu and then Settings and Gaming. If you don't play games on your Windows 11, then you can disable Xbox Game Bar. But if you are playing game and doing recording, then you should keep this option enabled. But if you use your Windows 11 only for productivity, then you can disable it. Now the next thing is about disabling certain Windows services that you might not be using. Go to search and search for services. And then here you need to find some services like this download map manager. If you are not using any map related program, then you can disable it. Right click on it, go to properties, select startup type disabled, hit apply and then OK. Next service you can disable is fax. Select, right click on it, go to properties and disable it. Hit apply then OK. You might not be using fax on your Windows 11, so you can disable it. Next up is Hyper-V. If you are not using any virtualization on your Windows 11, then you can disable this service as well. Like if you are not using any virtual Windows on your Windows 11, then you can disable this service. Next up is IP Helper. If you are not using IPv6, then you can disable IP Helper. But if you are using IPv6, then you should enable this option. In India, if you are using Jio Fiber Internet, you should not disable IP Helper because Jio Internet uses IPv6. Now the next service is Print Spooler. Some people says you can disable Print Spooler service if you are not using printer. But I won't recommend you disabling Print Spooler service because if you disable Print Spooler, then you won't be able to save files as PDF, print file as PDF on Google Chrome and some other browser, even on Microsoft Word and other Office products. But the next service you can disable is Windows Image Acquisition, WIA. You can disable this service. And then you can disable geolocation service as well. If you are not using any app which requires geolocation, then you can disable this service as well. Go to properties, select startup type disable, then hit apply and OK. And I will mention all the services which you need to disable in the video description as well. Now next thing is about cleaning Windows and users temporary file. Press Windows plus R key together and type there temp, then press OK. Click on continue. Now you can select all these files and then hit delete. Select all files and then delete. Skip the file which you can't delete. Now again press Windows plus R key together on your keyboard and type there %temp, then %, and then click on OK. It will open users temporary files and folders. Earlier we deleted Windows temporary files and folder. Now we need to delete users temporary files and folder. Select all these files and folder and hit delete. Skip the files which you are unable to delete. And doing these steps will significantly improve the speed of your Windows 11. And that's all for this video guys. Hope this helped. If so, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. Also press the bell icon to get notified about new videos and I will see you in my next video.